Coming up, we'll take a first look at how we're improving Office.com and the Office 365 app launcher to bring you more personalized experiences in the web. I'll show you how you can sign in to Office.com and get started with the apps, documents, and sites most relevant to you, how opening and switching between web apps is now easier, and how you can learn about the apps you already have with the new Office 365 Gallery. Let's start with Office.com. First thing you'll notice is that, of course, you can still get to your Office web apps right at the top of the page. We're designing Office.com to be the fastest and easiest way to get to your Office documents on the web, starting with an easy-to-remember URL. One of the new things we've done is to add a recommended section. This section surfaces documents with recent activity directly related to you. For example, in one of the documents I've created, I can easily see who's recently edited it. Equally, I can see that I've been at-mentioned by Julie in the team's marketing spreadsheet, and she also replied to a comment I left her in another presentation. The recommended section bubbles up the most important activity. Now, we've also improved the recent documents section. In addition to showing you all your recent online documents across storage locations, we've added a new column called Activity. Here, I can see everything happening in my recent documents, whether it's directly related to me or not, from sharing, to who's editing, to at mentions, and more. Next up is the Places section. This shows you all your recent SharePoint sites and those that you are following. As you can see here, I also have quick access to my recent OneDrive folders. All of my recent content is just here. And of course, search is another area of continual focus and investment for us. Imagine the convenience of being able to search across your Office 365 online documents, as well as your web apps, people, and SharePoint sites right from office.com. Well, that's what we've done. For example, say I've recently attended a presentation from my coworker. I know the content exists, but I don't know where it's stored. I'm able to just search by her name, Julie, as I know that she authored the document. And here in the search results, I can quickly see her files to find the one that I'm interested in. Behind the scenes, these new intelligent capabilities on office.com leverage signals across all of Office 365 to provide unified, relevant, and personalized experiences. Now let's switch gears and talk about what we're doing to make it simpler to open and switch between your web apps. The main view of the new Office 365 app launcher emphasizes those apps that most people use in Office 365. And if you use anything else regularly, you'll see it here too. You can still see every Office 365 app in your subscription by clicking All Apps. From here, you have a few options. I can search for Delve. I can open apps, pin them to my launcher, and learn more about them. You'll also notice a new section where any custom app your admin has specifically highlighted for your company or school is grouped at the top. I can pin my company's intranet portal, and when I go back to my main view, it's just there. And another way we're making it easy for you to get from one application to another is to navigate via recent online office documents. Where this gets powerful is that I can be in any Office 365 app experience and quickly switch apps via recent document. Such as here, I'm in my calendar. My recent documents will allow me to quickly transition to where I'm interested in going next. And directly from here, I can create new documents, just like that. To help further personalize the main view, for certain types of users, we'll also pin a few other relevant apps. As you can see here for teachers, we've pinned Class Notebook, Sway, and Forms, additional apps that teachers commonly use. And we'll do the same for other specific types of users, like small businesses. Outside of these defaults, any additional changes are up to you. You can pin or unpin non-default apps, or your view may change based on what apps your admin makes available to you. Now let's go back to office.com. From the app launcher, all I do is click Office 365 and I'm back. Beyond opening and switching web apps, we're also making it easier for you to learn about those that you already have access to via a single destination called the Office 365 Gallery. To get to the gallery, click Explore Your Apps from office.com. At the top of the page, we'll curate personalized suggestions for you. to learn about the apps that you already have available in your subscription. Below, you'll see there's descriptions for every app to help you decide which one is right for what you're trying to accomplish, links to learn more, and quick access to install when you have desktop or mobile versions available to you. So that was a first look at how we're improving Office.com and the Office 365 app launcher to bring you simpler and personalized experiences on the web. For the new app launcher, if you're an admin, keep checking the Message Center in the Office 365 admin portal for details of the rollout and access to additional resources. And don't forget to tell us what you think by clicking the feedback button in the lower right corner on office.com. Also, watch for the new Office 365 gallery and the changes to office.com begin to roll out in the next couple of months. Thanks for watching.